This is a repeat, ladies and gentlemen. I'm walking down to the pier. I'm going to buy some chips and have a nice time on the pier with one of my viewers. The difference is that I have the lovely Julia with me and Sean James Cameron from the Allotment Channel.
This week.
This week. This week's guest. Hello, Sean.
Hello.
How are you?
Quite hot today, in fact.
Oh, are you?
I've got my woolly jumper, on. But I think I might be in my t-shirt by the time we get down to
It's a lot warmer than I anticipated. And I've got my lovely woolly jumper on. The lovely Julia, you've got your coat on.
Yeah, I'm getting a bit warm at the moment because the sun is shining down on us. But as soon as we go behind a building and the thick shadow falls over us, it's cold.
It is cold. It's very cold in the shade. Let's go to the little lad who upstages us. And we'll decipher what that was later on.
It feels like I'm walking through a film set because I've seen these places so many times.
Yes, it's...
Because I'm thinking, this is where everybody was queuing back in March.
Oh yes, the zombie queue.
Yeah.
The zombie queues actually have disappeared now. Look, there's still the queues at full Wilco's.
Maybe it's an art installation. Shall we stop because of the music?
I was just saying, we'll get a copyright strike because there's commercial music blaring.
We'll see you after the break.
I hope you're enjoying this video. Why not help me make more and become a patron? A small donation really makes all the difference and keeps me out and about producing these magnificent presentations. So go to baldexplorer.com and become a patron today.
I filmed this morning and then I realised that it wasn't actually on.
I do a lot of that. Yeah. I turn the camera on and I think it's on and GoPro decides to take forever to switch on. Anyway, Sean, you're from London. For those people who don't know you, you run your own YouTube channel.
I'm Sean from London. I have a YouTube channel called The Allotment Channel.
What's it about?
It's about my adventures on the allotment.
Oh, there we are.
But I also have another channel.
Yes.
Just called Sean James Cameron with the Sean spelled S-E-A-N, which is about me walking around the streets talking to complete strangers. It's an in thing.
It's an in thing, yes. Do you come down to the seaside very frequently?
I've been down to Brighton a few times, but this is the first time I've been down in this area. And I'm quite shocked and surprised how close it is to London. It took me about an hour and a half this morning and now I'm by the seaside.
It's very much a commuter. We'll just step into the sunshine and cause the GoPro to work its auto exposure out
but
a bit better.
But it's not much of a... I was expecting to see pensioners on every corner, you know, a bit like kids. So it's not much of a retirement village as I thought it might have been.
You can't tell that they're not pensioners because they're all wearing
masks on, yes.
Yeah. But we're going to go now. We've got the choice of, it's just after midday as we record this, we've got the choice of either having a quick look at the beach.
Yeah, should we
and
go
the
down
pier.
There? Because I feel a bit crowded here. Perhaps,
yeah, it is crowded. Because the chip shop that we're going to go to is just ahead of us. But
right.
Before we do that, we could have a quick look at the beach.
Yeah, let's
and
just
what
go,
have
go and get some air.
Yes.
Because it does feel a bit.
Does it feel like London?
Well, it feels a bit as if I'm surrounded by zombies.
Argard.
Sean just asked me off camera, he said, is this like, you know, a proper seaside town? And I said, no, of course not. It's one of these inner city London towns that has a few pebbles and a couple of ponds.
No, that was based on the fact I saw a TV show by John Betjeman many years ago and he went to Neasden and they had music in the background going, Neasden. So I always thought the Neasden was a seaside town. So I went there one day and spent 3 hours trying to find the seaside until somebody said, you're talking out of the hat, mate.
Your behind.
The last video I did when I took someone down to the seaside, we went on the west side of the pier to add variety to my videos because they can be a bit samey. We'll go on the east side of the pier and we'll get a completely different perspective.
East side.
Oh yeah. What is it you do with the...
Where's the sand then?
Yeah.
I brought my bucket.
Mm-hmm. You might not need that. There is shingles.
Mm.
There's nothing nicer than chasing seagulls on the beach. There's probably a lot of things nicer. Running into the sea and getting your feet wet is another thing. Oh. Escaped. That's the sea.
It smells very seaside here, doesn't it?
What do you make of it?
I would imagine it's quite nice on a Sunday when there's nobody else here. You can just come down, sit down, contemplate life.
There is nobody else here.
Jojo, say hi.
Hello, Jojo. Little Joe loves the beach, doesn't he?
He does.
He should run in the water. Everyone should run in the water. Time to circumnavigate on Worthing's famous pier.
So, is there like a season for seasides then, when it's like busy?
There is a sort of season. I mean, it really starts in April, right, with the first school holiday, and then everything starts to open up until around about the end of October, this sort of time.
Oh, the end of October.
So much depends on the weather,
yeah,
because it's very weather dependent. So
is
some weekends
also during the week, or is it just a
place? As you get nearer to the summer, more tourists are here, and so people are on holiday. This year has obviously been very different, but generally, and in times gone past, and we haven't had it for a long time, at the end of the pier there would be a paddle steamer.
All right.
The Waverley would come in, but
well,
we haven't had
Waverley
that for ages.
In Penarth.
Oh, is there? Yeah. It might be the same one.
He's enjoying himself.
I love these stained glass windows, especially that one with the daffodils. Were these done by local schools, I'm guessing?
You can come down on the pier so many different times and sit and just get a completely different mood from it, and I really love that. Look at these rather amazing colours. These work really well.
There's no cafe in there anymore. They've ripped out the bar, both of them. There's no flooring even.
This is such a shame. Unless they're revamping it or something. But the old cafe in here has completely and totally gone. And I remember when it opened only a few years ago, probably about 5 or 6 years ago. And this is the old head. There used to be a nightclub in here called Rutherford's, I think it was. And that was a bit of a dive. I hope they don't go back to that. Certainly the pierhead in this 1930s cafe was absolutely superb. It's such a shame.
It's the type of place where I feel it's the type of place you could spend 6 hours gone without even thinking about it. You just relax the moment you come down. Beautiful. Beautiful.
Beautiful. I find it very relaxing. I don't get down here enough, and I think when you live somewhere and you have something as iconic as a pier, you often just take it for granted. But sometimes you need to have somebody with you who says that it's a great thing.
And I think one of the good things about lockdown is we've rediscovered our own country and even the area where we live, because you get up in the morning, you go off to the train station, and you don't actually know what's in your area. But this has given people an opportunity just to get out and to learn about this place.
Jibby time!
got to have chips when you come down to the seafront. Some people like fish, some people like sausage, some people like hamburgers.
I think I'm going to get a suntan.
I got a whopper. But that's it for this video. I think it's been a lovely
day.
It's been nice to have you down here in my hometown.
A beautiful day, and I can't get over how close this is to London, so I'll be back.
There you are. And Julia, thank you for coming down. Nice to meet Sean, wasn't it?
It was absolutely lovely to meet Sean.
And little Joseph has had a pleasant experience too.
Yep.
And I'm standing like a hunchback, so I'll stand up more straight. So there we go, from all of us here down in Worthing, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, follow and subscribe, become a patron and send bags of money. We do like
also
to...
press the bell icon.
Press the bell icon and you'll get notified. And we'll soak you and rinse you at the same time. Until the next one, from us all in Worthing, on a cloudless, blueless day. Blueless? Anyway, you know what I mean. Bye-bye.
Cloudless.
Last day of summer.